Okay, I'm ready.
El señor Walter Mercado.
Walter Mercado.
Walter Mercado.
Que ha salido para ti, Acuario, nada menos que la fortaleza, porque tú estás fuerte ahora, ¿eh?
We grew up with him. I can't think of an English language astrologer that would command the attention of millions of households.
Escorpio, te pones ahora insistente.
Some people who speak English do not understand how loved you are in the Spanish community.
He's very much his own incredible creation.
Famed astrologer Walter Mercado's style, mysteriousness, and positivity captured the eyes of over 120 million television viewers at the height of his career as he revealed their horoscope.
A new Netflix documentary highlights the life of the iconic gender nonconforming astrologer and his unexpected disappearance from the spotlight. Joining us today are the co-directors of Mucho Mucho Amor, Cristina, Costantini, and Kareem Tabsch. We welcome the two of you here this afternoon. Cristina, we're going to start with you. Walter Mercado, well known in the Latinx community. How do you describe him, and what do you think he was able to connect with so many people?
Yeah, you know, Walter is hard to describe if you didn't grow up with him, but we like to say he's a little bit Oprah, he's a little bit Mr. Rogers, but he's dressed like Liberace. So a lot of young Latino people grew up watching him. Our grandmothers, our abuelitas were obsessed with him. And so for us, he has this nostalgia of these moments that we spent with our grandparents during our childhood. So we have a lot of love for him, and he's a fabulous character.
So, Kareem, Walter kept his personal life pretty private. How did, first of all, you convince him to do this documentary, and then why did you guys want to do it?
You know, I don't think Walter needed much convincing. The reality is he loved being on camera. He got so much energy and enthusiasm from the lights, from being in production, and he had been away for quite some time. So I think he was enthusiastic about that. You know, for us, our memories of Walter are really tied up with our memories of our childhoods and our grandmothers. And he was such a unique character. We had never seen anyone like him in Spanish language TV, but certainly in English language TV, there was just no one like him. And we were so curious how he managed to achieve the levels of success and fame he did, always being so different, and how and why he disappeared all of a sudden. So we wanted to be able to tell that story in the doc and share some of that Walter magic with the world.
Okay, so in the documentary, we see Lin-Manuel Miranda, of course, known for Hamilton, when he meets Walter. He was also a big help in getting this documentary done, correct?
Well, you know, that was one of our first shoots, actually. Walter, or rather, Lin-Manuel was on the island for just a little while. He was opening Hamilton in San Juan. And he had just a few moments free. He told us that he didn't do any press, and this was the only thing he made time for. And I think, you know, because so many people who work in Hollywood have no access to Walter, didn't grow up with Walter. So I think having Lin, who was fanboying out about Walter when they met, who's like nearly in tears, really helped us get the project financed, truthfully. I think it showed people just what a huge deal he was if someone like Lin-Manuel could be freaking out over him.
Walter passed in 2019, but before he passed, he was able to see 20 minutes of this documentary. How amazing was that?
It was so, so special, you know, but there's so many cosmic moments. We submitted our cut of the film to Sundance on November 1st. Walter died on November 2nd. So I think he knew his work was done. Cristina and I were with him about 5 weeks before he passed, and we were able to show him the first 15 or 20 minutes. It was bittersweet, of course. He was not able to see the finished film, but he was very encouraging of us with what he did see. And we're so delighted to see that he's being embraced once again in all these corners of the world.
What do you want the viewers to get from the documentary?
You know, I think we live during a time with a lot of division, a lot of hatred, and these are messages that we learned very, very early on in life. They're the messages that our grandmothers taught us, they're the messages that Walter taught us, that really leading your life with empathy and with love is really what we all have to do. And I think he was somebody who strived to understand people who are not like him, who really strived to love everybody on this earth. And I think, you know, right now during these times, we could all use a little bit more love.
Amen. Christina and Kareem, thank you so much. Good luck with your documentary. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right. Mucho Mucho Amor is now available to stream on Netflix. And again, thanks to Christina and Kareem. Looks pretty interesting.
Yeah, it does look interesting. Yeah.
He does look like Liberace, doesn't he?
100%.
I love it. Really good energy, huh?
For sure.